On Bowen Island, sharing the road is getting easier thanks to a new transportation plan designed to make walking and cycling a bigger part of the island's transportation mix for all ages and abilities.
Transportation is really important for Bowen. You know, we've got nearly 4,000 people and they're spread out over the island, and so people are really dependent on the car. And that's why our new transportation plan is really quite broad in its scope, so we don't just have to rely on the car.
The transportation plan is based on three strategic goals: connections, choices, and health. So with connections, we're talking about efficient and reliable routes over land and water. And with the choices, we're looking at more alternative options for people to get around how they want and when they want. And with health, we're talking about both health of people and the environment. So really encouraging more active transportation and less generation of greenhouse gas emissions.
The transportation plan's 20-year vision to transform Bowen Island's mobility landscape is already taking shape. A new bike shed at the Snug Cove Ferry Terminal is one of the first elements to be realized.
As soon as we took the scaffolding away and let people in, they were using it right away. From the scooters and bicycles, we put the bike racks in as soon as we could as well. And I know that people are using it from morning till night. Soon they'll be able to charge their batteries on their bikes as well.
I've been commuting for a couple of decades from Bowen to places in the mainland where I work. Typically how I get down to the cove is either on a bike or on a scooter. But in rainy weather, it's not so great. But now we've got this little bike shed so that when you come back at the end of the day, your stuff will have dried off and you can just get onto a dry bike or a dry scooter.
There is a demand on the island for this type of infrastructure and facilities, so we're going to continue to build them.
A multi-use path traversing the island for cyclists and walkers is another top priority for the transportation plan.
The multi-use path routing was decided through a lot of community engagement, and it's really to connect all the major residential neighborhoods to the cove, the main transportation hub here with the ferry terminal, and all the main amenities, the schools, the services, and the shops. And we are on schedule to finish phase one this year.
Our ferry gets filled up. And there's 20, 25 people who've used a scooter or a bike. That means 20 or 25 spots on the ferry that's available for someone else. Just makes more opportunity for everyone.